Good morning everyone, myself Vinila. I am the team lead of this project and these are my team members Shashi Pavan, Shivani, Sai Ganesh Verma, Sai Ganesh and Priyanka. And coming to my team title, air pollution prediction using Rano Forest and Residency algorithms. We are under guidance of Dr. M. Prasad Rao sir.
Coming to abstract, due to human activities, industrialization and urbanization, air is getting polluted. The major air pollutants involved are carbon monoxide, nitro oxide and ozone. The concentration of the air pollutants is embedded air is governed by the meteorological parameter such as the atmosphere, wind speed, wind direction, relative humidity and temperature. In earlier techniques such as the probabilities and statistics etc. We are used to predict the pollutants involved in air, but those methods are very complex to predict. So we are going to use data mining techniques or better approach to earlier techniques such as the probability, statistics, etc. We are used to predict the pollutants involved in air, but those methods are very complex to predict. So we are going to use data mining techniques for better approach to predict the air pollutants and quality of air, which is needed to predict air relative humidity by considering various of parameters such as the CO, NO2, NO temperature, etc. So predict the pollutants of air, whether increasing year by year, decreasing. We are going to use the decision tree and random forest algorithm.
Coming to existing system, in earlier techniques such as probability, statistics, etc., were used to predict the pollutants involved in air. But those methods are very complex to predict. Sometimes the data is manipulated easily and data is not shown accurately. So we are going to use data mining techniques and decision tree random forest algorithm for better approach to predict the air pollution.
The proposed system we have using data mining techniques such as random forest and decision tree algorithm to approach the air quantity pollutants such as CO2 and NO2.
Start.
Coming to systematic is consist of four blocks: data collection block, data preparation block, building block and visualization block. First of all, come to data collection block, give the data to the data collection and prepares the data and it builds the data and visualize. Coming to our system method, we use two methods, decision tree and random forest method. Decision tree is one of the supervised learning algorithms which is used to represent the decision that is made based on condition. It is used for growth calculation and regression. The decision tree is always constructed from top to bottom. The first node that I have constructed from top is called root node. The last node is called leaf node. The internal nodes are placed between the root node and leaf node is called intermediate leaf nodes. Based on some conditions, the internal node splits and finally gives the output. The attributes which is used to make a prediction, the conditions used for fit the tree, the decision when to stop or whether the growth of the tree.
Coming to random forest algorithm, it is defined as the decision tree to do a regression and classification. Coming to classification, it is used for measure voting, and coming to regression, it is used for mean value finding or to calculate the mean value. The algorithm is more accurate and reversed and can handle a variety of data sets such as binary data, categorical data and continuous data. Random forest is nothing but a multiple decision trees. 75% of data set is considered for the training, and the training data set is used to submit the sample, and based on the attribute sampling, the different decision trees are to be constructed by applying the random forest algorithm.
We use Weka software for visualization the trees and graphs. These are the number of pollutants by year wise.